And welcome back.
Feathered Serpent.
To the next episode of Star Trek 25th Anniversary
Captain's
Blind.
Log, Stardate 5097.3. Starfleet reports major military activity in the Klingon sector near Hrakur, a planet on the edge of Klingon space. Intelligence indicates that the Klingons are mobilizing a large fleet to search for a renegade who is responsible for a disruption of unknown nature on that planet.
Oh my.
Federation sensors have found a faint energy trail leading to the planet Zamphor in the Digifile system. We've been ordered by Starfleet to track down the source of the energy and discover what happened on Hrakur before the Klingon fleet enters Federation space. If we are not successful, the Federation and the Klingon Empire may find themselves at war once again.
And that would not be a good thing. So, welcome back. This is episode 5, I believe, out of 7. The Feathered Serpent. And let's see... Look up on the computer what these systems are. I love the name Digifile. That's freaking awesome. Something about that, I like that. It's only one letter away from digital. Let's see if Spock has anything to say before we talk to the computer and stuff.
Nothing to report, Captain.
Okay, then we're talking to the computer and stuff. What is this? This is a Digifile system?
Digifile. A system near the Klingon neutral zone. Digifile contains 2 habitable planets, Digifile 3 and Digifile 4.
Imagine it.
Digifile 3, also known as Zamphor, contains ruins of a civilization that abandoned the planet approximately 20,000 years ago.
Wow.
And has been declared a protected world for archaeological reasons.
That's a lot of years ago. So this planet, Zamphor, I wrote it down.
Zamphor, the 3rd planet in the Digifile system, a Class M world. See Digifile.
I've already seen Digifile. How about this other planet? Whoop. Hrakur. I can't spell Hrakur.
Hrakur 4. A world in Klingon space, which has belonged to the Empire for at least 4 generations, governed by the Kenka family. The population of Hrakur is not known.
Anything else you can tell us about this Kenka family?
Kenka, flipped. A member of the Kenka family, an old Klingonese family of noble origins, the governing family of Hrakur. Flicked is the 1st Kenka to reach flag rank, and as such, has been posted back away from the frontier. Flicked has 2 sons in the service, but nothing is known of his wife or other children. He is believed to be the current commander of the Klerta, and one of the most respected commanders in the Klingon fleet. He is said to be an avid fencer.
We can keep on going with this, couldn't we? Klerta?
Klerta. Flagship of the Klingon Empire.
Ah.
A modified Klingon heavy cruiser. The Klerta engaged and severely damaged the USS Constellation before the Organian Treaty was put into effect at Alpha Aquila 7. The ship has seen little action since then, having been given the post of being the Emperor's flagship. The current commander is Admiral Licht Kenka. Its 1st officer is Boren Calorax. Both are considered highly competent officers with extensive battle experience.
Calorax. You know that guy, Boron? He's named after an element on the, periodic table.
Calorax. Boren. 1st officer of the Klingon flagship Klerta. Boren's father, Rajat, is the governor of Sagrad. Deep within the Klingon Empire, Boren Calorax is noted for his competency and his loyalty to his commander, Admiral Licht Kenka.
How far does this go, Rajat?
Topic not available, Captain.
What was the other?
Calorax. Boren.
Sagrad?
Topic not available, Captain.
Okay, we have exhausted the ship's knowledge on the subject. Just in case.
Arming weapons.
You know what? Not arming weapons.
Disarming weapons.
But shields on.
Raising shields.
How about that? I don't want to go in guns blazing, but I don't want to be vulnerable either. So this is... I believe it's here. Hoping so, anyway.
We're off course, Captain.
Damn it!
There are Elassi ships closing rapidly, Captain.
This is a mess now, isn't it?
Damage control standing by, sir.
Message from the Elassi captain, sir.
On screen, Lieutenant.
It's the other
one. You
shouldn't
have come here, Kirk. Now we must destroy you.
Weapons up.
Arming weapons.
Oh my god, how many are there? Alright, let's get this yellow one first, I guess. We're probably gonna die. Is this?
Hi, sir.
Show yourselves, damn it. Oh, they're flying all over the place. Wait. Wait, got him.
Weapons are flying.
The Enterprise has been destroyed.
I barely saw them. Yeah, it's the other one that I almost clicked on. Okay, so it's not here, it's here. Gotta be.
We're off course, Captain.
Instruments
indicate that we have crossed the Klingon neutral zone. Klingon ship is arming its weapon systems and raising shields.
Damage control standing by, sir.
Message from the Klingon commander, sir.
On screen, Lieutenant.
Enterprise, gonna die. You are in violation of Klingon. Raising shields.
Oh, hi! Oh, weapons are on.
Weapons.
That would be a good idea.
Offline.
Oh, we just armed them.
Are falling.
Oh, crap.
Are offline.
I didn't get to arm.
Alright,
let me check my map. Checking the map because I could have sworn that I got it right. Hold on. Are we going to Harakor? Oh, maybe not. I think we're going supposed to go to Digifowl then. This is Harakor. This is Strack here. This is Digifowl. Let's hope we're supposed to go here.
Captain, a Klingon battle cruiser has entered the system.
Open hailing frequencies. This is Captain James T. Kirk.
Not off course. It's a good thing.
Klingon battle cruiser, you are in Federation space. You must leave immediately.
I am Commander Taras of the Nizva. We are in pursuit of a genocidal criminal. We are performing an act of mercy in removing him from your space. Naturally, you will remove your vessel from this system. For your own safety, of course.
I think we can take care of ourselves, Taras, which is more than I could say for you, if the Nizra does not leave Federation space at once.
The guy's mouth wasn't moving, and I forgot to put the shields up this time.
You are in direct violation of the Organian Treaty, mister. If you have a problem, have your fleet commander take it up with them. If a Federation criminal were to pass into Klingon space, you'd be saying the same thing to me.
Hmm. Seems reasonable.
Who do you think you're trying to fool, Taras? Get your ship out of here now.
I'm gonna choose this option.
You are in direct violation of the Organian Treaty, mister.
If we are not allowed to capture this criminal, Captain, you may do this for us. We insist that we remain here to monitor the situation, but we will take no action. Provided that you can bring him to us in 12 hours.
Agreed. Vessels of war are not allowed in Federation space. You will pull back to the Organian neutral zone, and do so immediately.
Do we want to do that?
Agreed. Vessels of war are not allowed in Federation space. You will pull back to the Arganian neutral zone, and do so immediately.
I think we're pushing our luck, but let's try this.
You interfere in a just cause.
Oh my.
You respond to a cry for justice with arrogance? Now you shall see how Klingons deal with their enemies.
Oops, shield.
The Nizra has fired up his weapons.
Shields. Weapons.
Arming weapons.
I love the way he says that. Arming weapons. There's only one of you. Damage control sensors.
Aye, sir.
Now I'm saying it like Spock.
Sensors repaired, Captain.
Yay! Oh, there's more!
Disarming weapons.
No, don't do that. Hold on.
Aye, sir.
We're good.
The Enterprise has been destroyed. Load a previously saved game.
The Enterprise has been destroyed, really. I had no idea. Alright, so... Sorry, guys, a little hit and miss here. It was here, right? Pretty sure.
Captain, a Klingon battle crew.
Open hailing frequencies.
I am Commander Taraz of the Nizra.
I think we can take care of ourselves. You are in direct violation of the Arganium Treaty.
If we are not allowed to capture this...
Agreed.
All right. Let's play it their way.
Nothing to report, Captain.
Seriously. Are we supposed to orbit this planet then?
Entering standard orbit.
Now what? Beaming down, anything to say, Spock, now?
I have pinpointed the source of the energy trail from Hwakur.
Okay. So, guess we're beaming down.
Raising shields.
Oh, raising shields? No.
May I respectfully remind the captain that we...
Oh, no. This one.
Lowering shields, Captain.
Assemble a landing party. Unless we find this so-called criminal, we're going to war.
Hello there. Greetings and salutations. Let me just save right now because I made it past through all that crap.
Save new game. Replace, delete previous game.
Replace, yes. There you go.
There is a tall, slender, dark-haired man looking intently at you.
But Spock, you're already here.
You see dense vegetation in all directions. Luminescent insects swarm near a large tree.
They sure do.
You see dense vegetation.
With these eyes.
Feral red eyes glare out of the dark at you. You see dense vegetation.
The moon.
The moon of Digifol. Legend says that the gods of good and evil fortune live there and will glance back at those who look at them, and either a miracle or a catastrophe will soon befall those who gaze upon it.
Either a miracle or a catastrophe. Nothing in between.
You see dense veg...
I see dense vegetation.
Spock is analyzing the surroundings. You are James Tiberius...
Right.
McCoy is fidgeting around.
He is good at that.
Lieutenant Strage is carefully eyeing the humanoid.
Strage, huh? He's a Strage. Plus, we're going to do everything first before I talk to this guy.
He doesn't seem to be in a talkative mood right now.
Yeah.
The humanoid's adornments appear similar to those worn by leaders of Earth's early 20th century inhabitants of the South American continent.
What do you know about Earth culture? He looks like an ancient Aztec.
Meanwhile, the guy standing there like, I hope they talk to me before I die of old age.
Jim, that man is dressed in ancient Aztec clothing.
I believe you are mistaken, Doctor. His clothing bears a distinct resemblance to fashions of a much later period.
Mayan civilization?
I'm just a security officer, sir.
Everyone counts here, Straggy. Hi.
Greetings, my children.
Quetzalcoatl.
I can barely imagine that you have come so far.
I am Captain James T. Kirk of the Starship Enterprise. Did you know the Klingons are looking for you? I'm Captain James T. Kirk of the Starship Enterprise. What did you do to get the Klingons so upset?
Good choice. Either of them a good choice.
We're not your children, and we don't appreciate this wild goose chase you forced us into.
A no-nonsense approach.
I'm Captain James T. Kirk of the Starship Enterprise.
This one.
What did you do to get the Klingons so upset?
Quaint expression. I have done nothing to anger them. I did with them what I have done with everyone.
And exactly what would you have done with them? Entering Klingon space for anything puts the peace in peril.
True.
Whatever you did has them very upset. They're raiding worlds looking for you. And exactly what would you have done with them? Entering Klingon space for anything puts the peace in peril.
Gotta say I like this one. Slightly more than the other.
Jeopardize the peace? Hardly. Peace is what I preach. I am Quetzalcoatl, as you well know from the proud history of your world.
Quetzalcoatl? How fitting you would name yourself after one of the most bloody-handed gods in Earth's history.
Bloody-handed? My people love peace.
Your followers regularly sacrificed other believers to you after you left, offering you their still-beating hearts.
How nice of them. Yeah, right? Going with the whole Aztec theme, I have to admit to not being very aware of Quetzalcoatl or Aztec culture in general. Sorry, guys. Kind of feel like looking it up. I might do so after this Let's Play, after this episode. Unless I have to find out more about Quetzalcoatl to finish the episode, which, is a possibility.
Ha. You mean your followers love pieces? They slaughtered other believers hoping you'd return.
Ha!
Your followers regularly sacrificed other believers to you after you left, offering you their still-beating hearts.
Keep to the facts, you know?
Impossible. You must be lying!
And then your followers were destroyed, because when white men arrived on that continent, they were believed to be you in your promised return. Your people perverted your teachings, then were destroyed by it.
Foul, lying creatures! My gift was wasted upon you!
Oops.
Be gone!
Be gone? That doesn't sound good. Hey! Hi?
Here they are, not the inheritors of a noble Aztec world.
Oh, hey.
What you have said has greatly disturbed me. You should not lie so.
What?
You shall remain here until you have learned the error of angering Quetzalcoatl.
Well, you should have seen the other dialogue options. They were even worse, buddy. Where are we?
You are in a deep pit. It is a long, hard climb to the top.
All right, guys, let's stand on shoulders.
There is a light suspended from above by a chain.
Is that birds making all that sound?
Lieutenant Straggy is carefully examining the pit.
Is that a snake?
This particular snake doesn't seem to like your company and moves whenever you get near it.
Yeah, he's just stuck down here too.
James T. Kirk does not seem very happy with his current predicament. Spock is carefully examining the pit.
So I got two people carefully examining the pit.
McCoy is examining the floor of the pit.
And McCoy is examining it, but not carefully. And Kirk's just unhappy. What else we got? We could probably climb this.
There is a vine hanging down into the pit.
Roots.
You are in a deep pit. There are several loose vines hanging over the side of the pit out of reach. This is one of them.
Well, yeah, but there's others that are within reach.
He doesn't seem to be in...
He doesn't talk now, huh?
Those vines would be useful to escape, if we could reach them.
We could reach this one.
If I look like Houdini to you, I'm afraid you're going to have to pull the rabbit out of the hat on this one.
No enemies in sight, but supplies could be a problem if we don't get out.
Well, we could always eat vines and sneak. Hi, Sneak.
You get no response.
How rude.
You get no response.
How's the snake doing, McCoy?
It's a damn snake. Do you know what snake bite does? It can ruin your whole day.
We are not likely to find a way out of this pit with humor, Doctor. I suggest you concentrate your efforts to the problem at hand.
Do they always argue like this, Captain?
Oh, well, yes.
Yes.
Pretty much.
I'm picking up residual energy readings from the area where the alien's projection was. This vine is not likely to support our weight by itself, Captain. You would have to find some way to reinforce it.
Tie the snake around it.
It looks like a Zamphorian pit snake.
Oh my.
A rather common species in this region, noted by galactic herpetologists for their quickness. It is not venomous or dangerous to humans.
Well, McCoy, shows you what you know. Get Sneak. Oh, he went in the hole. The tiny hole. Oh, it came back out. Get Sneak this way. What if I stun the snake? Would that otherwise kill it, because it's just a little snake?
It is logical that an entity that professes to teach peace would render our phasers inoperative.
Our phasers are inoperative? Cooked Enterprise.
Fascinating. Our communicators have apparently been rendered ineffective.
Well, damn that guy. Let's... grab onto this.
The vine is attached to a tree above you.
Well, I don't want to take it.
The vine will not support you.
There is nothing at the moment for me to do there.
Someone do something there. Well, there's got to be a way to get the snake. The snake's there for a reason, right? Unless it's a red herring.
Are you nuts? There's no way I'm touching any damn snake.
Sorry, I meant to hit Spock.
The snake is too quick to be easily grabbed before it retreats, Captain.
He looks at you with a puzzled expression.
Get the snakes. Anything else around here?
There is a tiny hole in the wall at this point. Certainly no human could crawl through here.
Block the hole.
You fail to obtain anything.
Can I... We can't put that stuff there.
I see no logic in searching an empty hole, Captain.
I want someone to plug up the hole.
The hole is empty, sir.
I'm not putting my fingers in there, Jim.
Move something.
I certainly see nothing.
I meant to go back to me. Move the rock.
You pick up some rocks from the pile.
Oh, we got rocks. Cool.
These rocks are smooth and spherical, perfect for throwing.
Okay, well, first, I would just like to put the rock in front of this. Now, I can get the snake, right? It's so small. I move my mouse. We got it. My snake! Haha! See that, McCoy? Kirk wins the day again.
This snake is just waiting for a chance to sink its fangs into someone, especially young Starfleet security officers.
Well, I'm holding it, or it's in my pocket or something. Which is a great place for something to be when it wants to sink its fangs into somebody. Okay, so... attach snake to vine?
Nothing happens.
Nothing happens. Attach snake...
nothing happens.
Attach snake to...
nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Alright, what am I supposed to do with this snake? You guys don't realize I am playing this blind. I've never played this before. Get the rock again.
You fail to obtain anything.
I want that.
You fail to obtain anything.
It's good for throwing. I want to throw it at that thing. I don't see what... Can we go anywhere in here? I mean, I figured maybe not, but... okay.
There are rocks here quite suitable for picking up and throwing.
Oh, well, I can get more rocks from this pile, then.
You already have rocks.
I do? Oh, I still... okay. Alright, I have rocks left over. I did not even know this. Throw with this.
Nothing happens.
Throw.
Nothing happens.
Here. Throw with these vines. Hey, hey.
Fascinating. It did appear to knock the vine down near to the point where one of us can reach it.
Didn't they have baseball on Vulcan? Show us your fastball, Jim.
Baseball? No one plays that anymore. Good try, though, sir.
I remember Data saying something like, in the year 2075 or something like that. I don't remember the year. It was like the last baseball game or something like that. After that, everyone just played like simulated games. It wasn't like, it was funny because it wasn't, if I remember it right, it wasn't that far from, you know, relatively speaking, from the year we're in now. Okay, so... if we...
the vine will not support you.
I want to attach these vines.
The vine will not support you.
I don't know how to tell the game how to do that. Maybe if I throw...
nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens. The vine is attached to a tree above you.
I'm well aware of that fact. Maybe if I throw it at this... vine as well. Here we go. We're gonna tie the vines together. That's what I want to do. Oh, excellent.
The probability of getting the vine on the second try was only 36.53%. Well done, Captain.
Probability?
Thank you.
That was a perfect pitch if I ever saw one.
Oh, and thank right. you. We're on our way.
Steve Reich. Joining together, doing stuff. Let's see. Quetzalcoatl is out of luck this time.